Alright, let us play first. This hand is fine. We have two white sources. We might actually get to cast Avis in this game. She would have been good last game, but we didn't get to cast her. Like I said, I played bad. The Kaboomish thing early on, I think that just was bad luck. Him playing a 2/2 first strike on turn 3 is not going to be common. I guess, like, yeah, that's one of the only creatures that would have punished me for that. But the mind play was bad. Alright, so let us. We're just going to play our bear on turn 2, by the way. We're not going to hold it around for anything. Unless we draw another 2 drop, of course. That was a pretty good draw, actually. Can't cast anything. He's not doing anything. I think I want to keep everything in my hand, so I think I'm just gonna bash with these guys. If this guy had zero power, I would obviously loot, but I think I would loot. But I think one damage and keeping all this stuff is reasonable because I get to protect this with this the turn I play it by leaving open looter, and it looks completely normal. And this way I could heat worry this dude right now. As soon as I draw any land, that doesn't count. I could have discarded this, I guess, but I'm kind of beating down, so I don't mind this actually. It's another threat, and he's down to 11. He doesn't have any board. I have a removal spell that I'll eventually cast. I'm playing a 5/4 as soon as I hit a land. I could see looting that guy away, though. It means he's at 13. I have a random card in my hand. One less creature on the board. The way it's playing out, though, I'm pretty happy. Just get to attack with both my 2/2s now. And probably just play that. Yeah, I think so. Let's see what happens. I'm gonna attack both my 2/2s. I can just loot this Blast Firebolt too. Oh, he's chumping. Wow. In that case, I'm definitely playing this 3/3. Always make this guy indestructible. Yeah, I'm just gonna give the angel one more turn naturally, I think. I can't do anything. I don't have a white mana to convoke for white. Can't block it. Alright, that's good. I'm just gonna attack with the 2/2 and the 3/3. He probably has something, I just don't know what it is. Probably just a murder for this, which I'm just gonna let resolve. Oh, Hushwing. Sure, I'm fine with that. Okay with all that. Alright, so this is the nut, because we have this guy with protection. And it's literally free protection. If I didn't have so many rares in my deck, there's a better chance I wouldn't have played the ephemeral shields, but. Destroy all non-white creatures. I don't think that's very good here. But since I can win the game, I'm going to target this. I'm going to tap this and this. No reason I've shown that. Oop. Alright. Mass Calcify is interesting. It's not that good against me, so I'm okay with that. It basically deals with Siege Dragon and maybe the Enforcer. Did we see anything worth bringing an offering for? I don't think so. I don't know why I keep forgetting if he had anything exciting. Probably because he didn't have anything exciting. He's black-white again. Yeah. Still not really seeing much. I could bring in the Radiant Fountain, theoretically. Because two life against those accursed guys is actually pretty relevant. Because if they hit you six times, you go to 18. A seventh time, you go... It's 21 damage. So seven attacks on a 3-2 exactly. Is 21 damage. So if you go to 22 life, it adds a full turn on. Obviously, it's very rare that they're attacking exactly by itself that many times, but it still comes up. Yeah, outside of that, I don't know. This stuff's exciting. I make a board in a black, but my black's just not that good. Especially when, like, one of the reasons I'd be black is a Cursed Spirit, which is definitely not that good, and Festering Loom is awful. So yeah, I'm just going to keep it as is, and be back for the next round. Our next game.